Do you think that movement can be improved if breathing is overlooked? How important is breathing in terms of optimizing movement?
I don't think we can improve movements if we don't take breathing into the picture, because we know that breathing affects our core strength, our posture, the way we move, the way we feel, the way we think. And the human body is not just flesh and blood that's moving around. We have the nervous system that's connected to the brain. So we have this big holistic system. So breathing is indeed like 50% of movement.
Well, that's a large figure. And in terms of the connection with breathing, you're talking about core strength, and it seems that very often the emphasis is on the abs, but you're saying it's not just about that. We need to be going deeper. When you talk about movement, what do you mean? Is it a guy walking down? Is it a guy running? What sort of movement is it? Is it all movement?
It's all kinds of movement, because everything is connected to our posture. So it's even if we're standing or if we're sitting or lying down, every kind of movement.
If movement is dysfunctional, what are the risks? In terms of, do you have increased risk of injury? Is it going to impact performance? Is it going to hold the athlete back? Will they be more susceptible to lower back pain and things like that?
Pain, illness, physical dysfunction is really the root cause of so many things. So it can be physical pain, it can be illness, it can be mental disease or mental dysfunction. So movement is everything. I believe that the contemporary world thinks too much about the abdominals as being the real core, but the real core is dominated by the breathing, the pelvic floor, and everything that is around the core of our pelvis. So that's maybe the biggest misunderstanding in this fitness culture, is that we have to exercise the abs to get a better core function, but the core is really breathing. So if we don't incorporate breathing into our biomechanics, we can never get a better core strength. So core strength is diaphragm functionality. We have to get aware of how to activate and engage the diaphragm properly. And at least that's where I see the biggest misunderstanding. I don't know about you, Patrick. I would like to hear your view on that as well, because you are the breathing expert. But a lot of people misunderstand abdominal breathing with diaphragmatic breathing. But if we focus too much on the abdomen expanding, then we lose a lot of this core tension that we talked about. We lose a lot of the tension in the pelvic floor, in the glutes, in the deep abdominals, and then our posture gets out of balance. So I don't think that proper diaphragmatic breathing should be isolated to the abdomen, but rather to the rib cage. So just a little above the abdomen. I don't know about you, Patrick, but that's how I see it.
Yeah, I think it's a good point. I think it's even if we just consider how we breathe, you know, the brain is sending a signal via the phrenic nerve to the diaphragm. The diaphragm is moving downwards. You have the intercostals pulling outwards. So you're going to have movement on all four sides. And I think the risk is that when people think about abdominal breathing, but it's not specifically just abdominal breathing, but we want movement on all four sides, and especially lateral expansion and contraction of the lower ribs down around the 8 and the 9. The risk that when we talk about belly breathing is that people will be actively pushing and pulling in their belly, irrespective of their breathing. The other thing is, like, with such an emphasis on looking well, I think that's why, you know, having a six pack is seen to be that's what it's all about. But individuals with a six pack might necessarily have actually good function of the diaphragm.
Exactly. So the six pack is really dysfunctional because it acts as this inhibiting shell on the rib cage and on the abdominal. So we're not able to expand the diaphragm and thereby the rib cage to that degree that we want to expand it. So the rib cage, the six pack is one of the most misunderstanding dysfunctional concepts about physical training, really. So, and you can get a six pack by correcting your breathing or by doing other sorts of functional training that does not inhibit your diaphragmatic function,